sub-ring of a ring. Let R be a ring. A non-empty set capital S of R is said to be a sub-ring of R if S itself is a ring with respect to the same two composition as in R. Here the important point is S must be a ring by itself with respect to the same binary operation as we defined in capital R. Improper or trivial subring. If R is any ring, then the identity element 0 with respect to addition and the capital R itself are always subrings of R. These two subrings are called improper or trivial subrings of capital R. The other subrings, if any, are called proper subrings of R. Examples: the set of integers with respect to ordinary addition and ordinary multiplication is a subring of the set of rational numbers with respect to ordinary addition and ordinary multiplication of numbers. The set of integers with respect to addition and multiplication of numbers is a subring of the set of real numbers with respect to addition and multiplication of the numbers. The algebraic structure R, plus, dot is a subring of the algebraic structure C, plus, dot, where plus and dot are the ordinary addition and ordinary multiplication of numbers. From this we can say that the set of integers is a subring of set of real numbers with respect to addition and multiplication of numbers. The set of integers is a subring of the set of complex numbers with respect to addition and multiplication of numbers. Similarly, the set of rational numbers is a subring of the set of complex numbers with respect to addition and multiplication of numbers. Conditions for a subring. The necessary and sufficient conditions for a non-empty subset S of a ring capital R to be a subring of R are: the first condition is A belongs to S, B belongs to S implies A minus B belongs to S. And the second condition is A belongs to S, B belongs to S implies A minus B belongs to S. That is, we take any two elements from S, the difference must be in S and the product also must be in S. The conditions are necessary. Suppose S, plus, dot is a subring of R, plus, dot. We have to show that the conditions 1 and 2 are true. So we have to claim that conditions 1 and 2 hold in S. Since S is a subring, S is a group with respect to addition. Therefore, B belongs to S implies minus B belongs to S. That is, inverse exists for every element in S with respect to addition. Therefore, B belongs to S implies minus B belongs to S. Also, S is closed with respect to addition. Therefore, A belongs to S. Already we have shown that minus B belongs to S. Therefore, take minus B as another element from S. This implies S is closed. Therefore, A plus the another element is minus B belongs to S. A plus of minus B is A minus B belongs to S. Thus, the first condition is satisfied. This shows that the condition 1 holds in S. Again, S is a subring. S is closed with respect to multiplication. Therefore, A belongs to S, B belongs to S implies A into B belongs to S. That is the second condition. Hence, the conditions are necessary. The converse part, the conditions are sufficient. Suppose S is a non-empty subset of R and the conditions 1 and 2 hold in S. Now we have to show that S is a subring of R. This is condition 1, this is a condition 2. From condition 1 we have, condition 1 is A belongs to S, comma B belongs to S implies A minus B belongs to S. A comma A, let us take the element B as A here, therefore A comma B belongs to S implies A minus B belongs to S. Here A comma A belongs to S implies A minus A belongs to S. What is A minus A? A minus A is the identity element 0, therefore 0 belongs to S, and hence this shows that S has 0 element. Again, from condition 1 we have 0 belongs to S, A belongs to S. That is, in the place of A we take 0, in the place of B we take A, and hence by condition 1 A comma B belong to S implies A minus B belongs to S. 0 comma A belong to S implies 0 minus A belongs to S. This implies minus A belongs to S. This shows that every element of S has additive inverse in S. If A and B are any two elements of S, then minus B also an element of S, because A belongs to S implies minus A belongs to S, just now we have shown. Therefore, now A belongs to S minus B belongs to S, then from condition 1, A belongs to S comma minus B belongs to S implies A minus of minus B belong to S. A minus of minus B is A plus B. Therefore, A plus B belongs to S. This shows that S is closed with respect to addition. Since S is a subset of R, associativity and commutativity law with respect to addition must hold in S. Therefore, here we have shown that S is closed and S is associative. Zero element exists, that is identity exists, and inverse exists for every element of S, as well as the commutative is also true. Thus, all the five conditions, namely closure, associative, identity, inverse and commutative law with respect to addition hold in S. Therefore, S comma plus is an abelian group. Now we have to show that S comma dot, that is dot is a multiplication, is semi group, and the distributive laws also hold in S. From condition 2, it is clear that S is closed with respect to multiplication. Condition 2 says that A comma B belong to S implies A into B belongs to S. There is nothing but the closure property. Associativity and distributive law with respect to multiplication must hold in S, since they hold in R. Thus, the algebraic structure S comma plus comma dot is a subring of the algebraic structure R comma plus comma dot, where dot stands for multiplication, plus stands for addition. Results: intersection of two subrings of a ring is a subring. Union of two subrings of a ring need not be a subring. The union of two subrings of a ring is a subring if and only if one is contained in another, or if S1 and S2 are two subrings of a ring R, then S1 union S2 is a subring of R if and only if S1 is contained in S2 or S2 is contained in S1.